Hello friends, welcome to our channel. I am Ashanna, director of Sadhana Study Circle. I have been teaching mathematics last 26 years. In this video, I would like to teach you chapter 3 polynomials. This is the part 3 video on polynomials. In this part 3, we are going to learn formation of quadratic and cubic polynomials, relation between the zeros and the coefficient of a polynomial, third, division algorithm for polynomials. Let us learn one by one. Formation of first one, quadratic polynomial. The formation of a quadratic polynomial whose zeros are alpha and beta is k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. The quadratic polynomial whose zeros are alpha, beta is k into x minus alpha into x minus beta. That is k into x square minus alpha plus beta int x plus alpha beta. Here k is a constant real number, that is called to k into x square minus alpha plus beta, sum of the zeros. Into x, product of zeros. If we substituted various values for k, we can get various quadratic polynomials whose zeros are alpha, beta. Let us see one example. Find the quadratic polynomial whose zeros are 2 and 3. To find a quadratic polynomial whose zeros are 2 and 3, we have to substitute 2 and 3 in place of alpha and b. This is alpha, 2 is alpha, 3 is beta. We have the quadratic polynomial whose zeros are alpha, beta, k into x square minus alpha plus beta int x alpha beta. K के इंटू एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस टू प्लस थ्री इंटू एक्स टू इंटू थ्री, देन के इंटू एक्स स्क्वायर टू प्लस थ्री फाइव एक्स टू थ्री इज सिक्स. वी कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट वेरियस वैल्यूज फॉर के, देन वी गेट डिफरेंट क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल्स. इफ वी सब्स्टिट्यूटेड वन इन प्लेस ऑफ के, वी कैन गेट इफ k is equal to 1, then the quadratic polynomial x square minus 5x plus 6. So this is the required quadratic polynomial whose zeros are 2 and 3. Formation of second one, cubic polynomial. The cubic polynomial whose zeros are alpha, beta and gamma is x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma into, that is k into x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma into x square plus alpha beta beta gamma gamma alpha into x minus alpha beta gamma. We know these are this is the sum of the zeros, this is the product of zeros, this is we have to get multiply 2 and we have to add this. Let us see one example. Find the cubic polynomial whose zeros are 1, 2 and 3. If we substituted 1, 2, 3 in place of alpha, beta, gamma, we can get the cubic polynomial. One is the alpha, 2 is the beta, 3 is the gamma. Here we have that formula k into x cube minus alpha 1 plus beta 2 plus gamma 3 into x square plus alpha beta 1 into 2 beta gamma 2 into 3 gamma alpha 3 into 1 into x minus alpha beta gamma 1 into 2 into 3, that is equal to k into x cube 1 plus 2 3 plus 3 6 6x square 1 2 is 2 टू थ्री जा सिक्स, थ्री वन जा थ्री, एक्स वन टू जा टू, टू थ्री जा सिक्स, दैट इज के इंटू एक्स क्यूब माइनस सिक्स एक्स स्क्वायर, एट प्लस थ्री इलेवन, इलेवन एक्स माइनस सिक्स. इन प्लेस ऑफ के वी कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट वेरियस वैल्यूज. के इज रियल नंबर वी नो, बट के नॉट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. इफ यू सब्स्टिट्यूट ए वन इन प्लेस ऑफ के, if k is equal to 1, then x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. This is the required cubic polynomial whose zeros are 1, 2 and 3. Relation between the zeros and the coefficient of a polynomial. Type of polynomial: linear. Linear polynomial. General form or standard form: ax plus b. Relation between the zeros and the coefficient: 0 is equal to 0, here x is equal to minus b by a. Minus b means constant, minus constant term by coefficient of x. Coefficient of x. So relation between zeros and coefficients is 0 is equal to minus coefficient term by coefficient of x. Next, quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial: ax square plus bx plus c. This is a quadratic polynomial. For quadratic polynomial, the zeros are alpha, beta. Alpha, beta are zeros. Alpha, beta are zeros of the polynomial. Whose zeros of the polynomial is sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros means alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Minus b by a. Coefficient, minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, that is minus coefficient, minus coefficient of x by coefficient of x square. Next, product of zeros. Product of the zeros: alpha beta is equal to c by a. That means c by a constant term. C is your constant term. A is the coefficient of x square. Constant term. Constant term by coefficient of x square. Coefficient of x square. Next, cubic polynomial. The standard form for cubic polynomial is ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Sum of the zeros. Sum of the zeros. Alpha plus beta plus gamma. Here, alpha, beta, gamma are zeros of the quadratic cubic polynomial is equal to minus b by a. Minus here, minus b means coefficient of x square. Minus coefficient of x square by coefficient of x cube. Next, sum of product of zeros, product of two zeros at a time means alpha beta, beta gamma, gamma alpha is equal to C by A means C means coefficient of x by coefficient of x cube. C means coefficient of x by coefficient of x cube. Next, product of zeros alpha beta gamma is equal to, this is the product of zeros. Product of the zeros alpha beta gamma is equal to minus d by a. Minus d by a. Here d means constant term by x cube term, coefficient of x cube. Minus constant term by coefficient of x cube. Division algorithm for polynomials. If p of x and g of x are any two polynomials with g of x not is equal to 0, then we can find polynomials q of x and r of x such that p of x is equal to g of x and g of x into q of x plus r of x, where either r of x is equal to 0 or degree of r of x is less than degree of g of x. We have already learnt this. This is the division rule. We know dividend is equal to divisor into quotient. Divisor into quotient plus remainder. So we know divisor, here is the divisor, this is the dividend, here is the quotient. Here is the remainder. From this we know the remainder is R of X. Remainder is 0 or less than the divisor. But in this polynomials, degree of R of X is less than the degree of G of X. Degree, we have to compare degree. From this we have the following results in this discussion. What are the results? If Q of X is linear polynomial, we know linear polynomial AX plus B, this is the linear polynomial. If Q of X is linear polynomial, then R of X is equal to R is a constant. If the divisor is a linear polynomial, then the remainder is constant term. Next, second, if degree of Q of X is equal to 1, then degree of P of X is equal to 1 plus degree of G of X. So here this is the P of X, this is the G of X, this is the Q of X, this is the R of X. Here, if degree of Q of X is equal to 1, if it is 1, then degree of P of X, this degree of P of X is equal to 1 plus degree of G of X, 1 plus degree of G of X. Next, third result, if P of X is divided by X minus A, then the remainder is P of A. If P of X is divided by X minus 1, then the remainder is P of 1. So like that. If remainder is equal to 0, we say Q of X divides P of X exactly. Exactly means there is no remainder, means 0 remainder. Q of X, R, Q of X is a factor of P of X. So these we understood from this division algorithm. Thank you, children. Thank you for watching my video. If you haven't subscribed my channel, you immediately subscribe and press the bell icon to get latest updates. And also share it to your friends to help them and encourage for me to make more interesting videos.